Hello all and welcome back to Swapnil's Analysis, and I'm Swapnil. Today we are going to discuss a very interesting short story of James Thurber. The name of the short story is The Unicorn in the Garden. You all probably must have read this short story already, or if you have not read this short story, then I would highly recommend you to read this short story. So, who was James Thurber? James Thurber, he was a cartoonist. Now, as we all know that cartoonists, they have a very different kind of a vision or different kind of a perspective of the life. So, being a cartoonist, he always found some kind of a humor, means there is a kind of a humor in his short stories. So, this short story is also very interesting, and it also reflects upon the marriage and the boringness of the marriage, means especially after when both of the couple, husband and wife, when they become of middle ages, means after the 15 or 17 years of marriage, there is a kind of a tardiness, there is a kind of a boringness, natural boringness that occurs in marriage life. So this story is about the same. It is about a couple who they are in their mid-40s, probably in their mid-40s. Why? Because their age has not been informed in the story. So what happens here that both of them, they want to get rid of one another because they both are now fed up of their marriage, seems fed up of their one another. So here the story is divided into two parts, means it is not structurally, but to understand the story, we first have to understand the beginning and then the later, and how it is a kind of a trap, how the husband, he builds a trap, and how his wife, she falls into that trap, and how very easily he gets rid of her. That is the story all about. The story is very interesting. There is a kind of a mild humor in the story, and probably I just love the narration style of the story. As I have told you earlier, that this is a fable. Now, what is a fable? Fable is a moral story. It informs us about a kind of a moral thing. So this is a modern fable. Therefore, this story commences traditional trademark of a fable, that is, once upon a time there was a man, or once upon a time there was a village. So this story commences thus: once upon a sunny morning, a man who sat in a breakfast nook looked up from his scrambled eggs to see a white unicorn with a golden horn quietly cropping the roses in the garden. So this is the story about, as it has informed us about a man, and when he was having his breakfast, he saw a white unicorn with golden horn. Now, what is a unicorn? Unicorn is a mythical and mythological figure. And therefore, what happens here that no sooner did he see the unicorn, he then ran to the bedroom where his wife, she was still asleep. He roused her and he informed her. What did he tell her? That there is a unicorn in the garden eating roses while she was still asleep. And here the reaction of wife implies everything, informs everything. She opened one unfriendly eye and looked at him. When she was totally annoyed, why she was annoyed? And first of all, when her husband, he informed her about that there was a unicorn eating roses in the garden, she did not react. Her reaction implies everything, informs everything. And what did she say? The unicorn is a mythical beast, means there was a kind of annoyance, there was a kind of anger. The unicorn is a mythical beast, and she turned and she again continued her sleeping. Then what did he do? He did not say anything. He came down and he went into the garden, and there he pulled out some lilies and he gave lilies to the unicorn. And unicorn ate the lilies offered by the man, by the husband, very gravely. And then what happened? That as the unicorn ate the lilies offered by the husband, he ran again back to the bedroom, and there he informed to his wife. What did he say? The unicorn, he said, ate a lily. Again, his wife, she was now totally annoyed, and he had already broken her sleep twice. So she was angry and she just sat up in the bed. And she was looking at him very icily, very angrily. And then what did she say? You are a booby, she said, and I'm going to have you put in the booby hatch. Now, booby means stupid, mad person, or a person who doesn't know how to behave. That is a kind of a booby thing. And booby hatch means mental hospital. So they, at the time, means this story was published around in 1940s. So at the time, in the 1940s, there was a very common tradition that when a person, if he behaved abnormally, people, they would contact the mental hospital, and that was his place. Then he would be hospitalized in the mental hospital. So she warned him that you are a booby and I am going to have you put in the booby hatch. Then the man, her husband, he did not like the words booby and booby hatch, means mental hospital. And he left the house while the unicorn was grazing in the garden, means imaginary unicorn was grazing in the garden. And what did he say? We will see about that. He walked over to the door. He has a golden horn in the middle of his forehead. While leaving the bedroom, what he said, after when his wife, when she was angry, she said that you are a booby and I will have you put in the booby hatch, means in the mental hospital. He personally did not like the words booby and booby hatch. Therefore, while leaving her room, he said, we will see about that. Who will go into the mental hospital? And while leaving the bedroom, what he said, he has a golden horn in the middle of his forehead. Means there was a golden horn middle of his forehead, and he told her and he left. And he left the house. Then what happened when, here the first part ends. As soon as the wife realizes that, okay, her husband, now he has gone, she suddenly woke up from her bed, and she thought, okay, this is the time to get rid of her husband. This is the time to get rid of this man. So immediately she called police and also psychiatrist. And she said, my husband, she said, saw a unicorn this morning. So when the police and the psychiatrist, they both arrived at her house, and she informed, while both the police and the psychiatrist, they both were sitting before her, and she said, my husband, he saw a unicorn this morning. The police looked at the psychiatrist, and psychiatrist looked at the police. He told me it ate lily. My husband told me that when he offered lily to the unicorn ate the lilies. So again, the psychiatrist looked at the police and the police looked at the psychiatrist. They were totally shocked and they were totally surprised. He told me it had a golden horn in the middle of its forehead. Again, my husband further told me that the unicorn had a golden horn at the middle of his forehead somewhere. Then, when that woman, that wife, she informed the police that my husband, he told me that the unicorn had a golden horn at the middle of his forehead, there the police realized that this woman, she is out of her mind. And at the solemn signal of the psychiatrist, the police jumped onto the wife. Why? Because she would not run away. Because the police and both of the psychiatrists, they had realized that the woman, she is actually a mad. And therefore, out of her madness, she was speaking about a unicorn and that too having a golden horn. So the police, he jumped onto the wife and he seized the wife. And she, as we all know that she was a very of a strong character, she resisted the police and the psychiatrist, both of the people. But somehow they were able to subdue her. They were able to control her. And as they were controlling the house, as they were controlling the wife and they completely seized the wife, then the husband, he entered back into the house. And then the police asked the husband, "Did you tell your wife you saw a unicorn?" "Of course not," husband said. "Of course not. The unicorn is a mythical beast." See, when first the husband, when he informed to his wife that there was a unicorn grazing in their garden, eating roses, then the wife said that unicorn was a mythical beast. The same answer here was repeated by the husband. What husband said? Husband said, "Of course not. The unicorn is a mythical beast." And then the police said, "That's all I wanted to know." The psychiatrist said, "Take her away. I'm sorry, sir, but your wife is as crazy as a jaybird." Means your wife is insane or extremely crazy. And therefore, we are taking away your wife. Taking your wife to the mental hospital because she has lost the control of her mind and she babbles whatever comes in her mind. Therefore, she is speaking about she saw a unicorn, she with a golden horn, because it was a kind of an imaginary thing. A person, he cannot see a unicorn. That too with a golden horn at the middle of his forehead. So everyone assumed, means the police and the psychiatrist, they both assumed that this woman, she has lost the control of her mind. Therefore, she takes away. And therefore, so they took her away, cursing and screaming, and shut her up in an institution. The husband lived happily ever after. Here, the story is about the marriage where both the husband and the wife, they want to get rid of one another and they were in search of that. So initially, at the beginning, when the husband, he informed about the unicorn to his wife, she behaved as if she has no interest about his what he was talking at all. And she showed to him that, "Okay, I don't have any kind of interest and you are a kind of a booby, you are kind of a stupid." Therefore, she also says that you are a booby and I will put you in a booby hatch. And there, husband, he knew his wife very well. He also knew what his wife would do next. Therefore, After informing her about the unicorn, that too with the golden horn, he left the house and immediately. Thereafter, a wife, she immediately sat up. She called the police, she called the psychiatrist, and she started narrating. Here, initially, a wife who considered her husband as a stupid, as a booby, later on proves to be herself as a stupid and booby. Why? Because she falls into the trap set by the husband. And therefore, she wanted to put her husband into the mental hospital because of his babbling, but he very shrewdly constructed this plot, constructed the trap where his wife, out of her stupidity or out of her overconfidence, fell into that trap, and later on she herself ended into the mental hospital. This is the story. Therefore, what is the moral of the story? There is a moral given here. What is the moral? Don't count your boobies until they are hatched. So, this is the moral of the story, that where you should not consider someone a stupid person, because here she considers her husband as a useless man, as a useless person, as a stupid person, but later on he proves to be the more intelligent than herself. So this is a very beautiful and interesting story, and we will definitely are now going to discuss some of the very interesting and famous short story henceforth along with our poems that we are going to continue discuss. So what do you think about this short story particular? Do read this short story and please let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and if you still have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to it so that you will be able to know whenever I upload a new video and more about the literature. Thanks for watching.